Hi. When everyone is merely following rituals, there are no performance awards. There cannot be. In today's bridge, in the jungle of artificial bidding, and often also draconian bureaucratic diktats that seek to criminalize routine good bridge builds, with little breathing space for individual expression. Every now and then, however, a deal comes up that affords a chance to individual freedom. Bridge bidding then takes the form of an art. Witness this deal from the HCL Gold Teams final that concluded last weekend. You are sitting north. This is deal 11, South dealer. South deals and opens one heart, five carded heart, wide range, maybe 11 to 20, 12 to 21, whatever. Your RHO waste passes, you bid one spade with four carded spade. On your left, east bids one notrum, partner bids two clung, and waste doubles. Let us check what this double was. It was competitive. What is your reading of the hand? Well, one notrum is something like 15 to 17 high card points. The double should be 8 or 9. So that is about 22 to 23 high card points. You have 9. So that makes it 32. Leaves only 8 for partner, but partner opened one hat, so let's give him 11. So that makes it to a total of 43 high card points. Alice in Wonderland, in utter exasperation, would have said, "Who added an extra king to my pack?" Isn't it that kind of a situation? So on your left, east bids 2 diamond after this one notrum bid, partner bids 3 club, and west bids 3 diamond. So after this round of bidding, what is your reading of the hand at this point? Well, as we said, we see 3 extra high card points, but it is unlikely that east in the sandwich position has bid with less than 15, nor is it very likely that west has made a competitive double with very few points. Cannot have two fewer than say 7 or 8. So the only conclusion is that partner seems to have opened light. Now, why would partner open light? The only good reason would be if partner's hand is highly distributional. Now, does further bidding corroborate this hypothesis that partner's hand is distributional? As you can see, you have 5 diamonds and you've seen diamond bids on either side, so likely partner has a void in diamonds, and possibly 6 hearts, 5 clubs, 2 spades, or even 6-6-1. So that is one of the reasons. That seems like the reason why partner has opened one heart and rebid clubs, 2 clubs and then 3 clubs. Now, what do you think is the prognosis of this hand? What is possible on this hand? Now, partner is roughing diamonds, you are roughing hearts. You got ace of spades, so there is no fast loser in any of those side suits. Partner likely has a club owner, possibly ace. You don't know what partner has in hearts. If he only has heart honors, that would be unfortunate, but that is slightly less likely. So what is the possibility on this hand? Well, if you can imagine two aces with partner, and if you can imagine roughing three hearts in your hand, the possibility could be even all 13 tricks. If not 13, 12 should be on cards, 11 should be certain. Now, the next question is, what do you do with this hand? You cannot bid any number of hearts or spades, because those bids would be taken as natural bids and partner is likely to pass. So the only bids available to you are 4 club, 5 club, or a highly imaginative 4 diamond bid or 4 note. You cannot really have an understanding for this kind of a situation. You will have to innovate and you will have to hope that partner gets you right. Not that this kind of experimentation is advisable in the final of a major event, but there is always a possibility that you could bid imaginatively, and there is always a possibility that 11 or 12 tricks are easily available in a club contract. So you could always finally get back to clubs if something goes wrong. Hopefully that wouldn't be at 7 level. Now with all this in mind, let us see what actually happened at the table. North doubled at this point. With King 10 9 small and diamonds, he couldn't resist that attraction of a juicy penalty. And then it went past 3 heart. Pass, 4 club, pass, pass, pass. The double apparently having applied a sort of break, partner wasn't encouraged to bid higher after that double. So it went 4 club, pass, pass, pass. It was only a non-vulnerable position. Are the names of the players? P. Sridhar, playing for Texan Aces, had plotted to bid this hand beautifully, artistically, going slowly, starting with 1 heart, then bidding 2 club, then 3 club, and then 3 heart, amply conveying that the reason for his opening was distribution and not points per se. Slow and steady is often the mantra for many good activities. Take yoga or cooking or sex or many other things, for example. And in this particular case, that slow and steady template, that mantra, was used by PS to convey his hand beautifully, although the high card points where only 9, the distribution was wild and it needed many bids to get it across, and he actually managed to do that with 4 bids up to 3 heart level. So that indeed was very good bidding. The final result need not bother us, simply because when good ideas, innovating ideas are in play, these kind of things do happen. But this is how these ideas will finally get tested and get planted in good bridge players' minds. So I really like this bidding and I wanted to describe this. Now, in the other room also, one Texas Asian player made a brilliant bid. Let me show you. So notice the bidding here. It was 1 heart, 1 spade, 2 club, 3 club, 5 club. Kiran Nadar also had started with 1 heart and probably would have gone equally slowly, just like PS in other room, had the bidding afforded that chance. But what happened at this table? There was a brilliant pass by East, Milind Athavale. Milind Athavale, mind you, is a second generation bridge expert. His father, Madhav Athavale, was a top expert in his own right in 70s and 80s. And many of his hands, his brilliant plays had got published then, one or two in the Illustrated Weekly of India, which was a very good magazine that was published in those days, and many other deals in other bridge publications. Now, Milind has just carried on from there, and as you can see, in this sandwiched position, one heart, one spade, holding three kings, and not rating this hand to be worth too much in value, Milind simply passed. What was the result of that? The result was forcing bids or imaginative bids were no longer available to North South. Of course, they still reached 2 club, 3 club, 5 club. They reached a 5 club contract. But I doubt if they would have had a chance to reach 6 club or 7 club here. Whereas in the other room, after that one notron bid and competitive double, I have a feeling that there was an opening for a slam bid. So the net result was that 5 club made in this room and 4 club played in the other room, but two beautiful things. One, a beautiful bidding template for a hand that has less than the stipulated high card point opening, but more by way of distribution, and secondly, a brilliant pass even with 15 high card points. Now just imagine, what if the rules of the jurisdiction said that your opening has to have 10 minimum high card points, then South wouldn't have been able to open one heart here and would have had to find some alternative bid. Now this is the problem that occurs when laws and restrictions are made without a proper understanding of the at the table bridge problems. No matter what your methods are, no matter what your techniques are, you will always get hands that don't fit anywhere. And if you are forced not to innovate, not to find good bids, not to find bids that exceed, that go out of bounds, that cross the limits in some sense, but are appropriate on the hand for proper description, if those bids get outlawed, if some bureaucratic law bars you even from considering those bids, bridge would be a poorer game, less exciting game, less interesting game. And I think all of us, we should try our best not to allow such undue restrictions to affect bridge players' freedom. I want to leave you with that thought. I hope you like this discussion. Thank you for joining. Bye for now.